Hi friends. So on the 10th and 11th of January, I was at the Lifestyle Design Convention, hosting it, and that's why I've missed a couple of video blogs, but I'm gonna catch up because I want to make sure there's one for every day. So this one will be dated, predated for one of the days I missed. So I'll just keep doing them and catch up. So I think I'll be sharing a lot of thoughts from that convention because there's a lot of stuff going on in my mind. And I was doing stories. I was telling stories, but I think that doesn't resonate so much with me anymore right now. So I'll skip. I won't finish that for the rest of this month as I planned. I'll just go back to doing the talking about the ideas, and this is what I love doing. And so that was one of the epiphanies from the convention, was to do what you love, do what drives you, do what calls you. And talking about ideas, especially ideas of psychology and personal growth, those are the things that are really calling me right now. So I'm gonna talk about those things. So one of the maybe one of the things that just popped in my head is a quote from originally from Rumi and Timothy Mark at the convention. He talked about it. The quote is, "What you seek is seeking you," which is just this idea that the things that you want in life, the things that you are looking for, whether consciously or unconsciously, the things are also looking for you. There's lots of ways to interpret that, and I think you might think of it as destiny, or what you put on earth to do, that will find you. You will come across that because you're looking for it, but it's also looking for you. And it's kind of a nice concept to think about, that you're, that everything that you seek in the world is also seeking you. And I mean, we don't have, on the one hand, I think that you should have, a belief, a high locus of control. You should believe that you have a lot of control over the world, and take a lot of responsibility for as much as possible, because it's very empowering to take action, to drive you to take action. You should believe that the action will actually do something. On the other hand, we have to admit that a lot of things happen due to chance, and that we drive very little in our lives. Well, at least we exclusively ourselves, almost everything has components of choice and chance and so on. So, when our lives go on and things start to fit together, and we continue becoming our own unique self, as Steve Jobs said, the things connect in reverse. When you look back on your life, you'll notice how things connect and make you the person you are. And of course, that will be powerful and unique. We're human beings. We have these enormous brains, which are the most complex objects in the known universe. And there's no other. We can expect nothing else but to become incredible, inspiring, powerful beings. So, yeah. Keep pushing, like take every day just a little step, and you'll become powerful beyond measure. I don't know. I feel like I've blabbed a little bit, and I don't know if that was very clear, but I hope I've passed something on. In some ways, the convention was a little bit was not a little bit, it was very spiritual. I came back and felt like I was having a spiritual experience, and that's very difficult to communicate. I felt a lot of love for everyone, just walking along this on the street and just seeing people just just I felt love towards them as a crazy transcendent experience. Sort of reminded me of what Sam Harris talks about in Waking Up, how when he took some hallucinogens, he suddenly had this feeling of complete love, unconditional love towards everyone. And they felt like that yesterday. Just because of the compassion in that room, in the convention, there's 100 people who are all positive, compassionate, loving people, and we just shared that energy for 2 days, and it was really, really powerful. Yeah, well, that's it for today. I'll see you tomorrow.